Aladdin Creations.
Hello guys, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. Previously we have discussed two malaria topic, what is malaria and malaria parasite life cycle. So today in this video we are going to discuss our third malaria topic, how to diagnose malaria in laboratory setup. We'll discuss in this short video. One of the most important aspects of malaria detection is the clinical diagnosis, which is based on patient clinical symptoms and physical examination. Most common physical symptoms include open fever, chills, sweats, headaches, muscle pain, nausea and vomiting. In falciparum malaria, these clinical symptoms may get severe: confusion, coma, neurological focal signs, respiratory difficulties and anemia are some of them. But the physical findings are often non-specific, and you have to keep in mind that clinical findings should always be confirmed by laboratory tests to indicate positivity for malaria. So let's talk about laboratory tests available for malaria detection. For the diagnosis of malaria, patient blood sample, which is collected at any time during their course of illness, is required. Microscopic diagnosis. The gold standard method for malaria confirmation is microscopic examination of thin and thick blood smears, which is stained with Raman mask stains. The thick blood smear enable the laboratory person to determine the presence of malaria in patient blood, while the thin smear allowed its speciation of malaria type and detection of parasitemia. Blood smear examination is relatively simple and available in medical laboratories as routine hematological test. Antigen detection. Tests for malaria antigen detection are available as rapid diagnostic test, which can be used as alternative to microscopy. Mainly, these kit methods are based on immunochromatographic assay format and provide result in 2 to 15 minutes. But once the rapid diagnostic test gives positive result, it is necessary to carry out the microscopic examination for confirmation and detect parasitemia. However, these rapid diagnostic tests are easy to handle and quick compared to the other methods available. Molecular diagnosis. Molecular diagnosis is mainly based on polymerase chain reaction or PCR, which detect the parasitic DNA. This enable to detect very low number of parasitemia, which occur in acute phase of disease. Therefore, the sensitivity is high. Also, this can be used to confirm the species of malaria, as it gives high specificity as well. But molecular diagnosis is costly and time-consuming than other methods. Serological test. Antibody detection methods for malaria are available as indirect immunofluorescence assay, IFA, or enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, ELISA. But currently these tests are not used for the diagnosis of malaria. We can use serological tests to detect past exposure history, especially in case of surveillance program. Drug resistance test. In vitro diagnostic techniques and molecular tests are available in special laboratories to carry out antimicrobial susceptibility tests. In vitro tests are culture tests, while the molecular tests are based on PCR or gene sequencing techniques to detect molecular markers. However, these methods are highly sophisticated and rarely performed. In addition to diagnostic tests, which I discussed previously, it is important to conduct the initial workup, carry out complete blood count and routine biochemistry test. Even if the person does have a positive malaria test, these additional tests will be useful to determine whether the patient has uncomplicated or severe manifestation of malaria infection, such as severe anemia, hypoglycemia, renal failure, hyperbilirubinemia and acid-base disturbances. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain some knowledge about how to diagnose malaria in laboratory setup. Anyway, in my next video, I hope to discuss with you how to identify and differentiate malaria parasites on blood dyssemia. So guys, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.